Matter in our surroundings. Hello students, welcome to today's class of Matter in our surroundings. When we see our surroundings, we can find variety of things in different shapes, sizes and textures. Everything in our surroundings is made up of material named as matter by scientists. Even stones, clouds, stars, plants and animals are all considered as matter. The things which we find around occupy some space called as volume and have some mass. Indian philosophers have classified matter into five basic elements such as air, earth, fire, sky and water and called them as panch tattva. But the modern day scientists have classified matter based on their physical properties and chemical nature. Now let us learn about physical nature of matter. Two types of views came into exist regarding nature of matter. The first view is, matter is continuous like a block of wood in which there is no space between the elements and are tightly packed. Whereas in the second view, matter was made up of particles like sand in which space exists between them. Now let us perform an activity to determine the nature of matter. Activity 1. Let us take a 100 ml beaker, fill half of the beaker with water and mark the level of water. Now take some sugar or salt and dissolve in water. Can you observe any change in water level? No, we cannot observe any change in water level. Then, where did the salt or sugar disappear? From this, we can think that matter is made up of particles with spaces and the salt or sugar particle has spread into the spaces between the water particles. Now let us find how small these particles are. Activity 2. Let's take 2 to 3 crystals of potassium permanganate and dissolve them in 100 ml of water which turns into pink color solution. Now take 10 ml of this solution from first beaker and mix into 90 ml of clear water of the second beaker. Again take 10 ml of the solution from second beaker and mix into 90 ml of clear water of the third beaker. Repeat the same process of diluting the solution 5 to 8 times. Do you think any change in the color of the solution on diluting process? Yes. We can find change in the color of solution from dark to light color on dilution. From this experiment, we can think that one crystal consists of millions of tiny particles which can change the color of large volume of water. Each particle divides themselves into smaller and smaller particles and it reaches a stage where it cannot divide further. So, after repeating the dilution process, pink colored water turns into light color but still slightly visible in pinkish color. The same experiment can be done with Dettol instead of potassium permanganate, but there we can find by smell, not by color. So we can conclude particles are very small in nature. Now let us learn characteristics of particles of matter. From the above experiment of dissolving of sugar or salt in water, we found that particles are equally distributed in water and also particles of one type distributes into spaces between particles of other type. The other examples are tea, coffee and lemon water, etc. From this, we can find that there is space between particles.